sort of preaching to choir, we all know water is life, and rivers are the lifeblood of our communities. Almost everybody in America lives within a mile of a river or stream. And 65% of the people in America get their drinking water from our rivers, and yet we aren't stewarding the way we should. And you know that very well. And it's creeping here. It's creeping towards this watershed. Every day it feels a little more threatened. One of the ways American Rivers tries to protect rivers is through our annual most endangered river list, which lists the 10 most endangered rivers, not the 10 worst rivers, which we probably can say 10 every year. There's just so many bad, dead rivers in America. But the 10 rivers that are threatened that year by some action that people across America react to maybe prevent them from becoming more endangered. Last year, our number one river was the Upper Delaware because of the threat of fracking. And the fight didn't stop there. We're fighting with citizens like you to try and get states to institute moratoria to prevent fracking. We're working in Congress every day to prevent, to try and pass the Frack Act, which will close the Halliburton loophole. Building, as Josh said, Senator Cardin held it here just this week on the threat of fracking. People started to hear it. And please stay tuned, because we're not done. American Rivers isn't done, I know you aren't done. But the 2011 Most Endangered River Award are coming out on May 17th of this year. And my press office would not let me say what rivers are going to be listed and what the number one river is, but let me just say that American Rivers is going to continue to do its part to keep the dangers of fracking out front and center. And I want to thank you all for doing your part to do the same. And thank you very much on behalf of everybody in America.